99.99% of Americans were against this style of critique of Islam, the Muslim world should have demonstrated that America is a great country. 99.99% of Americans refuse to burn our Quran. What a great country. They should carry a leaflet that says, God bless America. But that's not what happened. Now, assume at Egypt, one man wanted to burn our flag, and the entire crowd stopped him. We would be demonstrating in the street and say, Egypt is a great country. But that's not what happened, you see. So we have to look at the seriousness that no matter what we do, these people are against the United States of America. They want nothing but its destruction.
Right. Just by our existence, we could do absolutely nothing and they would still hate us. And of course, as you point out, we're not in favor of evangelizing by insult. But, you know, when the Da Vinci Code came out, nobody issued a fatwa on Tom Hanks, or when Lady Gaga's Judas, or Serrano's photo of Christ on a crucifix and a glass of his own urine, and the U.S. taxpayers paid $15,000 for that so-called artwork, nobody demonstrated. So what a difference between Christianity and Islam.
Well, the difference is very clear. We know our God is true. He exists. He can defend himself. We don't need to defend him physically, because a God that does not exist and that has basically used very demonic means to establish a kingdom for Lucifer on this earth needs his people to follow him and needs to apply violence in order to implement what they want. So we believe in a true living God. They believe in a God that is not true and is not living.